Welcome back to Couples in Christ. I'm Pastor Tim.
I'm Patty.
And we're here for part two of, I think it's just a two-parter.
Yes, it is.
Of manger, cross, and crown.
Yes.
The manger, the cross, and the crown are important to who Jesus is, and they are also important to as to who we are in Christ.
The manger can be a symbol of renewal and regeneration for us.
Mm-hmm. Jesus even says we are to be born again.
But we can't stay infants in our faith. We have to grow and mature.
So here's what Jesus said in Luke chapter 9, verse 23. He said, "Whoever wants to be my disciple must deny themselves and take up their cross daily and follow me."
So when we take up the cross of Christ, we do two things. We surrender our wills to God. So we take our plans and give them to Him, right? But we also submit to His plans. So we're taking His plans and making them our own.
This is what Jesus did, right? Jesus submitted Himself to the will of God, to God's plan. And we are to follow what Jesus did, right? He followed God's plan, not His own plan. Yes. And that's the same type of thing we're to do.
So we hear a lot in the world that things are just meaningless. Maybe you thought or said this yourself.
Right. Now, this frame of mind can lead to moments of hopelessness and a life filled with superficial relationships.
We hear, life is falling apart. I'm just not going to think about it. Sound familiar? It sure does to us.
Mm-hmm. Just below the surface, a fear is often bubbling away. A fear of the future just tends to eat away at us just underneath the surface of the skin.
We can't completely ignore the reality of our lives.
Mm-hmm. So what is your reality? What are you trying to avoid this holiday season?
So I know one thing that we try to avoid a lot this season is my health. I kind of been diagnosed with some things. I had breast cancer back in 2006, I think, or so.
Somewhere there.
I had some chemotherapy, a lot of chemotherapy, and it's made changes to my body, and my heart is reacting to that now. And so we have to make some life changes, and it's been hard for us to decide on these life changes and to have to think about them at the holiday season as we're going through. And then on top of it, my immune system then gives me pneumonia. And so, you know, it's just been quite a chaotic time. And so it's been hard to focus on the Lord and what He has planned for us. And we are scared about the future because we don't know
what that'll bring,
what it will bring. But we have confidence in the Lord, right? We have confidence that He does have plans for us. And we have to be willing to submit our plans to Him. And we can honestly admit with you that it's easier said than done, right? It's not so easy to do those two things, to give Him our plans and to take them back ourselves. So this focus on the birth of Christ is really important so that we can remember what He did for us.
Mm-hmm. We have to remember, as Christians, we don't have to remain in these frames of mind no matter what is happening in our lives or in the world around us.
Right. As believers, there's not just a manger and a cross, right? There is the promise of a crown of our very own. And it's so much even better than my Mickey Mouse reindeer ears, which are fabulous, but it's 100,000 times more fabulous.
We will live forever side by side with the King of Kings.
And we'll receive a crown along with this wonderful recognition. And these are some of my favorite words in the Bible. We're going to get to my other second favorite words of the Bible. But well done, my good and faithful servant.
Mm-hmm.
How wonderful is that going to be to hear?
Oh, so glorious. this makes us different, odd even, and that we should stand out in our society.
Instead of worrying about what is going on in the world, which is hard, I'm not saying this is easy because there's COVID and there was politics for so long and still is, and health issues, marital problems, trying to defy age, keeping a tight grip on our possessions in an unstable economy. We live with all that, but as Christians, we live confident because we live in the light of Christ.
Mm-hmm. And it's a light so bright that no darkness can ever overcome it.
The manger brings us this new birth in Christ. The cross brings us salvation. And the crown brings us hope for eternal life.
So there you go. Manger, cross, and crown. All three should be present in your life. And we pray. Dear Lord, we are so glad that You have so generously provided for us these three gifts.
Help us always to keep our new birth close to our hearts.
Help us to remember the great sacrifice on the cross for our salvation.
And help us to anchor ourselves in the hope of eternal life.
Amen. That's it for today. We will see you again tomorrow. Have a blessed day in Christ.
Bye, guys. Love each other.